Charles Ramsey was a restaurant dishwasher in Cleveland, Ohio, when he led the police to rescue three women who'd been held hostage in a neighbour's basement for a decade. It was one of the biggest stories of the year. He gave a colourful, detailed account of what happened to TV news crews covering the story, and his wisecracking manner gained him international coverage and instant fame. But no one could have predicted what happened next. Inigo Gilmore has the story.
All my life. All my life. All my life. I ain't never had nothing.
Thanks, you get rough. When you live in the ghetto, you gotta survive no matter the pain. Be hurting like you be hurting, but for certain, this is the game. It's Thursday night in Cleveland, Ohio. Local hip-hop band Bone Thugs and Harmony pulled in a big crowd. But there's another star attraction here too. Charles Ramsey, the man who became a mega celebrity during the biggest story to hit the city for many years. Ramsey was involved in the rescue of a woman called Amanda Berry, who had been missing for 10 years, presumed by many to be dead. It turned out she'd been kidnapped and was being held with two other women by Ramsey's neighbour, Ariel Castro. He later committed suicide in jail. It was an interview with a local network that catapulted him into internet stardom, instant celebrity.
I'm talking with Charles Ramsey. He's a neighbour. Walk me through again what happened this afternoon. You heard screaming.
Heard screaming. I meet my McDonald's. I come outside. I see this girl going nuts, trying to get out of a house. Detective Gregory Cook says, Charles, do you know who you rescued? I said...
What was the reaction on the girls' faces? I can't imagine to see the sunlight, to be around people.
I knew something was wrong when a little pretty white girl ran into a black man's arms. Something is wrong here. Dead giveaway. Dead giveaway.
Charles, thank you very much.
Dead giveaway.
My neighbor got big testicles because we see this dude every day.
Spawned a rap song, now available on iTunes. Then there was this parody, which went viral.
I was watching WWE, eating some McDonald's, because I'm loving it.
Something is wrong here.
Ramsey's even known in Taiwan.
本周当红炸子鸡兰溪好邻居英勇救女动画重现.
And to crown it all, the star of an online game where he attacks Castro with hamburgers.
Yeah, giveaway.
Back at the club, Ramsey, who just a few months ago was washing dishes, is mobbed by well-wishers.
He's awesome. Yeah, he's amazing. Oh, he's absolutely a local hero. Yeah, for sure.
And it's unintentional. There wasn't any... He didn't go after it for the notoriety or anything, you know? He was just... It just happened, and then everything just blew up after, and it was so dramatic and so interesting.
This is a city desperate to move on from the grim story of kidnap, rape, and abuse endured for so long by three Cleveland women. Ramsey's happy to play the local hero. But getting to talk to Charles Ramsey is no longer that easy. He now has a manager, Chris, with a K. As Charles says, he's become his mouth.
This is my mouth here.
Come on, Chris.
Yeah, no, we'll call you guys tomorrow, seriously.
There it is.
What I mean? Right now, you're not going to get anything. He's just going to say, yeah, no, yeah, no.
You guys are helping him out, basically.
Correct.
Can you tell me just briefly what's that?
No, I mean, I don't get on camera.
Oh, okay.
I'm too cool for that.
We kept filming as off camera, Chris explained that we would have to pay to play.
I don't even want to waste your time. How much can you guys do for I mean, Charles is at the point where, you know, we're doing paid talk.
As Charles headed off with the band, an agreement was reached to meet the next day without money changing hands.
You know me.
Doing what you're supposed to do.
Next day, Charles arrives in his BMW. His manager, Chris, is on hand. Time for a little pep talk.
Yeah, just mention your social media accounts, you know, like whether it be like Twitter. Say, hey, I'd like to talk to you or something. You just make it personable. Charles J. Ramsey, Twitter.
The Twitter. I don't understand how that works. Now, this is what it's called. It's called Charles J. Ramsey, right? That's the Twitter account. But I don't understand what that means, what it is. So I'm going to follow myself.
The world of instant celebrity is clearly still a steep learning curve. Around? Charles had agreed to an interview, but it was more like a performance.
Ariel Castro made us famous.
Charles, what's good about Cleveland?
Me? I need to be on South Park. See what I'm saying?
Why do you want to be on South Park?
It's a cartoon. You don't want to have
no,
your own?
No, I know South Park, yeah.
No, I mean, you don't want your own cartoon? Come on, bro. You got some ideas for me? I'm listening.
Sure.
Three Stooges, right? It's four now. I'll be the black one. We got to pull pranks on people that don't get pulled pranks on, like, you know, Donald Trump and Barack Obama, Henry Kissinger.
So you got lots of ideas going forward.
Oh, yeah.
The fuck is Charles Ram?
It is. It looks like, to me, it's maybe just my head now, that since old Mr. Castro there is gone, that this whole city can breathe a sigh of relief now. You know what I mean?
I know who you are.
He's still getting a lot of love from the locals.
It's good to meet you. You're a good man.
This despite media reports about his domestic violence convictions. He had an unusual response when I asked about it.
You know, he said you had some past issues and so on and so
on. So does Ike Turner. Was that just didn't stop him from marrying Tina or being famous now, did it? He's still Ike Turner.
Strangely, he was also reticent to discuss the rescued women.
Are you in touch with the ladies at all? Is
there... What ladies?
The ladies you helped rescue.
Of course not.
Are you able... I mean...
Of course not.
He seemed keen to move on from what happened, and maybe there was a reason.
How are you?
Across town, there are now flowers in the place where Ariel Castro's house of horrors been demolished. We found a Spanish-speaking neighbor whose story was not heard at the time. She had a rather different take on Ramsey's heroism.
What did he do then? Well, he was around at the scene, though.
He was around at the scene because he lived right next door. But he went to take the credit. Why? I don't know.
So did he help in any way to rescue them?
No.
Can you check that with her?
¿Quieres saber que si este Ramsey te ayudó en cualquier momento a jalar puertas?
Nada, absolutamente nada.
Nothing, absolutely nothing.
We wanted to ask Charles about these claims, and I thought we had a date.
If you need me again, you know what to do. You call prison, I'm going to come a running.
Okay.
Thanks again.
We did call him again, but he'd vanished. A man who was catapulted into the orbit of instant celebrity is trying to keep the Charles Ramsey show on the road. So I open the door, we can't get in that way. The body can't get through the door. Only for some in Cleveland, the idea that Ramsey embellished his story is a dead giveaway. Even though some people challenge his story, Charles Ramsey continues to ride the wave of his instant fame. Perhaps he's only too aware of the flip side, instant obscurity.
Inigo Gilmore reporting now tonight's main news. The government has scrapped plans to launch a national fleet of advertising vans warning illegal immigrants to go home or face arrest. It's now planning to impose a £200 a head health levy on temporary migrants as part of a target of raising £500 million from foreign nationals who use the NHS.
That's it from us. You can watch the entire programme again on Channel 4 Plus One.
Yes, but that's Channel 4 News. Good evening.
Good evening.